When the Perseverance rover touched down on the surface of Mars on February 18, 2021, a new era dawned for Martian exploration. Aboard the $2 billion vehicle is the sample caching system, specifically designed to collect and package rock samples to be stored on the red planet's surface. But how will these samples find their way back to Earth? Stay put as we explore the Mars Sample Return Mission, NASA's most daring Martian project to date, here on Elderfox. Back in 2011, a report from the National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine stipulated that the top priority of NASA's planetary exploration program in the coming decade should be to begin a Mars sample return campaign, a three-mission project to collect, launch, and safely return samples of the Martian surface back to Earth. The report stated that NASA should invest in a sample caching rover as the first step in this effort, and so the Mars 2020 mission began. After almost 7 months of interplanetary travel, Perseverance descended into the Jezero crater during 7 minutes of terror on February 18, 2021. With the primary aim of sample collection, landing in the Jezero crater was in no means a coincidence. Believed to have once been home to an ancient Martian lake, the Jezero crater is one of the most intriguing places in the solar system from an astrobiologist's point of view. Its thick layers of clay may hold the key to unlocking the history books of past Martian life, and so collecting samples from this area may prove to be a vital step towards our understanding of the universe. Now that Perseverance is safely on the Martian surface, it can start collecting and packaging samples. The Mars 2020 mission aims to do this over a period of at least 500 sols or Martian days, after which the next phase of the Mars sample return mission can begin. So once Perseverance has collected and packaged Martian rock samples, the billion-dollar question is, how will they get back to Earth? Perseverance is only the first step of the three-pronged Mars sample return mission. The second stage involves sending two further spacecraft to the dusty red planet, a sample collection rover, and a two-stage solid-fueled Mars ascent vehicle. Developed by the European Space Agency, the sample collection rover will do exactly what it says on the tin, retracing Perseverance's tracks on the Martian surface and collecting the prepackaged samples along the way. The plucky rover will be of a similar size to the Opportunity and Spirit rovers sent to Mars by NASA in 2004, and the first rover of its kind to arrive on the Martian surface sent by the ESA. Once the sample collection rover has retrieved all the desired samples, it will return them to the Mars Ascent Vehicle, or MAV for short. Once here, the samples will be deposited and grouped together in a sample return canister. The next step will be the most ambitious chapter in Mars exploration to date. The sample return canister will be launched from the Martian surface into orbit, the first time such a feat has been attempted on another planet. These two spacecraft are scheduled, at time of recording, to launch together from Earth in January 2026, and will send the samples into Martian orbit sometime around spring of 2029. Once there, the samples will rendezvous with the third and final phase of the Mars sample return mission. In October 2026, the ESA-built Earth Return Orbiter will be blasted off towards Mars with one single objective: collect and safely return Martian samples to Earth. Arriving at Mars in 2027, the orbiter will gradually descend itself into a low Mars orbit using ion propulsion, attaining the desired altitude by July 2028. Here, it will retrieve the sample return canister and begin its return to Earth during the 2031 Mars to Earth transfer window, where our two planets are closely aligned. The samples will then be returned to Earth in a thermal protection system, specifically designed to nullify any biohazard contamination concerns. Since it is currently unknown whether life forms exist on Mars, the mission could potentially transfer alien organisms into Earth's biosphere. The scientific consensus is that the potential for large-scale effects from such an event is extremely small. However, every precaution must be taken, and the returned samples will go through a similar quarantine process to the Apollo astronauts of the 20th century. NASA has even gone as far as proposing the construction of the Mars Sample Return Receiving Facility, a similar containment facility to that of the Lunar Sample Laboratory used between 1969 and 1972. The Mars Sample Return mission is not the only mission of its kind in existence. China is also preparing a similar mission to return samples by 2030, 1 year earlier than the planned return of NASA's collected samples. This may mark the dawn of a new space race between global superpowers, though at this time, the United States and China will be vying for pole position in Martian exploration. Russia, Japan, and France have also proposed sample return missions, however, these are yet to materialize. Within the decade, we are likely to see samples from Mars return to Earth, paving the way for the next logical step in cosmic exploration, landing humans on Mars. With growing interest in landing humans on Mars from both public and private bodies, returning Martian samples has never been more prevalent for space exploration. The sample collection hardware, Perseverance, is already deployed and operational on the Martian surface, though the return vehicles are yet to be produced. If such a feat can be accomplished, it will have demonstrated humanity's ability to go to and return from the Martian surface, meaning the future missions will develop technologies required for the first human landing on another planet. Keep up to date with the samples collected by the Perseverance rover by clicking here to see our special series following the rover along its journey. Thanks for watching Elderfox. Remember to subscribe and hit the bell to keep up to date with the latest discoveries.